we are so thrilled to bring you this participant session, right? It's wonderful channeled advice from Vagrein. Recently, a participant sent me an email with all of the timestamps for some really amazing parts of a Vagrein session. So you should know that this particular video is coming to you through the inspiration of this participant wanting to share these powerful messages with the entire collective and not just keep them for themselves. One of the messages in here is for anyone who has a dream about something that they wish to accomplish, but they are not entirely sure on how to bring it into physical reality. So it's a manifestation question. Another one explains that everything in everyone's life is absolutely on purpose. So we can either go directly there, or we also have the free will to go about it in some other ways and meander through our experience with challenges and invitations and maybe the less frequented route to get to where you want to be going. Then there's also a powerful and clear explanation on how the higher self uses your emotions to communicate and nudge you towards your highest truth and highest self-expression. So please enjoy this participant session.
Okay. I guess I always just in part in coming to speak with you, it's also just because I hear and feel strongly the thoughts and nudgings in my own head, but sometimes I need validation from outside myself that this is real and that this can come to be. So I have a really grand vision of a center, and I want to make it exist here in this physical world.
Focusing upon it is a good direction to head in. Speaking about it is a good direction to head in. You do not know who or what will hear what you are saying and decide that this is the train that they would like to jump upon. So, as much as possible, do share this dream with others. Do share your personal story of why this is your dream. Do share your desire for helping others. Do share that grandness of it. There are not many beings who are visionary in the way that you are feeling visionary in this now moment. Do not diminish yourself because of whatever conditioning you have had in your life that has told you that you are not the special one that can make something happen. You are indeed, because you exist, the special one who can make anything that you choose happen. If this information is coming through you, it is an offering to you. It is an invitation to you for what you can, if you so choose, decide to do with your life, to do with your service, to do with your love. And as you develop it within yourself and allow yourself to know that whether or not it is manifest or simply in your heart in a strong and confident manner, that is enough. Because let's say it does not manifest. Let's say that for whatever reason, bricks and mortar or the administrative whatever does not come to be within your lifetime. In your holding fast to this dream of having this sort of thing, describing it to others, you do not know if someone down the line does take on this idea and make it into reality for someone. So this message is for you and for anyone who has a dream. Focusing upon it is enough. Do not look for that confirmation, whether it be from us or from any other external source, from a bank account, from a manifestation of the right people coming together. Do not worry about confirmation of it. The confirmation of it is that non-physical energy frequency that is coming through you. We are not saying this because there is a possibility or a probability it was not going to manifest, but because this is the fastest way to make something manifest, to go full steam ahead in your mind and heart towards that thing without doubt. Because doubt is absolutely useless. The energy of what creates worlds has no doubt. The dew does not doubt which petal it is landing upon in the early morning. It is simply going with the direction of whatever is guiding it. Therefore, you can be in that exact same way. You can be a leaf on a tree that is blown by the wind in the perfect moment that lets go or brings seed to another part of the forest. Allow yourself to be confidently delighted in the inspirations that are coming through you. And when you see those catalysts or those stimulus for emotions that have led you to this place, as opposed to framing them as the sorrowful things that they can be framed as, you can plaster that delight upon those things, upon your partner or the circumstance or the situation or your life in this now moment in the same way. This is what we would suggest to you. If, and we do believe, you do have a desire to see this manifest in the time span that you have in your physical reality. Because nothing that manifests is ever not on purpose. So those inspirations that are coming through you, they are also on purpose. The sorrow that you're feeling is on purpose. Everything, yes, the delay even of this meeting is on purpose, because you can never not be on your purpose. It is simply a question of asking yourself in each now moment, would you like to go directly to that thing, or would you like to have a bit of playing around? In other words, will you align with what your higher self is telling you is an option? Or will you exercise your free will to not align with what your higher self is telling you? What is your higher self telling you?
That I'm where I'm supposed to be and I'm doing okay.
Yes, indeed you are.
Because I beat myself up a lot because I feel so difficult on the inside. But then I remember the very first meeting I had with you, where what you discussed with me is how I was pushing all my emotions down and how the next phase for me was to let them up. And you said, feel and let go, feel and let go. And I think I'm still in that process, so it doesn't feel wonderful, but, and you know, sometimes I could beat myself up of why do I feel so miserable? But then I just say to myself, but I need to feel and let go. I have to get it up and out in order to get to the place of joy. I just, the sadness and the feels like it may have no end, but.
Well, sadness does have no end. In that, sadness is simply an indication and it is a measurement of where you are on the scale of being in alignment with yourself. There is no judgment in this. It is simply in the same way your car has different dials or indicators to tell you what is going on. So sadness in itself is not anything at all. It is simply energy. What does change in time as you feel and let go is that you begin to realize that sadness is not only not negative, but it is something that is serving you deeply. And as you begin to master those panels of indicators on the car, the vehicle that you are, you understand when sadness comes up, that is simply an indication that there's energy that needs to process through, and perhaps even behind that, a belief that has caused it in the first place. As you are feeling the feelings, you will uncover naturally the beliefs that are stimulating them. And as you uncover these beliefs naturally and allow them to enter into your mind, and yes, cause the sadness. For example, earlier in this session, you said, I have to admit that I am alone. This caused sadness in your system. The sadness allowed through will highlight that statement to you. Eventually, in thinking that thought, you will realize every time I think the thought that I am alone and doomed to be alone for the rest of my life, I don't feel so well. At some point, you will realize that the reason why you feel sad when you think that thought is not because that thought is true. It is because it is the obligation of your higher self to send you a shot of sadness when you think that thought, because it is not in alignment with what your higher self believes about your life. First of all, you are never alone, because that is not a possibility. That is not an experience that is actually accurate in the existence of all that is. You cannot be alone because you are made of the same stuff of everything else. So you are one with everything. But yes, on a human level, there is that sense of loneliness or that conditioning around it. But even on that level, it is not true that because the circumstances that have arrived to you, you are doomed to a life where you are alone your whole life. Many other people will come in and out of your existence, many other connections, many other beautiful stories and experiences. And you, letting go of this belief that you must be alone forever, will navigate those in many beautiful ways. This is what your higher self is certain of. And so, if you say, I am needing to accept that I will be alone forever, then your higher self, of course, must send you that shot of sadness, must set the indicator to sad in order for you to realize that you are not in alignment with the truth of what is.
The feelings are a barometer, basically.
Indeed, they are. And that is also the reason why, in feeling enough of them, when sadness arises at some point, instead of you diving into it and allowing it to take over your physiology and allowing it to take over your actions, which is the commonplace in terms of human behavior. Normally, for example, someone is angry, they throw a punch. Someone is sad, they fall to their knees and rip their clothing. But once you have become accustomed to the levers and pulleys, the indicators, the barometer, that is your system specifically, when you are sad, you do not need to fall to your knees and rip your clothing. You simply say to yourself, wonder what this is trying to tell me. Or when anger arises, you say to yourself, perhaps there is some place where I would like to set a boundary. This is what your enlightened ones are often practicing. You look at them and they are unfazed by the circumstance around them. They are not unfazed. They are not feeling emotions, for it is not possible to not feel emotions without suppressing them and then doing damage to your system over time. What they are doing is they have learned what the emotions are meaning for them and responding accordingly with their sovereignty. This is also something you have been desiring in your experience. Therefore, it is also something that is being offered to you to practice with.
You just spoke of the process of how we become an individual self is by learning and living and doing. We develop a personality and a character, and it becomes, is it connected to but kind of independent from our higher self?
Yes, in some ways, that would be a correct way to describe it. You are all that is, but in your individuated aspects, you have made choices of how to be. Those choices are guided by the inner being, by the higher self, and overseen by it, yes. So there is nothing that you are doing that is not approved of or confirmed by your higher self. But it is in its experience seeming to be disconnected with independent ability to choose. And that is what free will is. It is your ability to choose to do something other than what feels in alignment for you. The repetition of this makes it feel normal for you to be out of alignment. There are no adults who currently are not comfortable with being out of alignment. That statement perhaps grammatically does not work in the way we intended. Let us reattempt. For human adults, being out of alignment does not feel as uncomfortable as it is meant to.
Because you become habituated to feeling that way.
Yes, you are very comfortable with being unhappy. You are very comfortable with being muted or low frequency or low energy. If you see children, when they decide that they are going to play with a ball with their friend on the other side of the park, they do not walk to the other side of the park. They are running at full speed to play with the other child. And they are bouncing off the walls from morning to night. In fact, their parents do not know what to do any longer with a five-year-old. It is the same with your dog. The energy that you have as a physical being is quite a lot higher than what most people are able to experience. And it is because you choose to be regularly going against your higher self that your frequency feels so low. You are then comfortable with that. Many of you are comfortable to wake up in the morning, to go to a job you hate all day, to come home, to sit on the couch, have no energy to do exercise, have no energy to have a conversation with their partner, and then to go to sleep. And that is an exhausting day. In fact, sitting on the couch and watching television is their way of trying to regain energy. This makes no sense, but it is frequent what occurs. Being in alignment is the fastest way to be motivated to have plenty of energy throughout your day. It is the way to be inspired to eat the correct things. It is the way to be inspired to meet with the correct people, to have the correct relationships. But you are habituated to not do these things. That is something that is changing on your planet, because now it is becoming too uncomfortable to be out of alignment. And people like you who have chosen to come into service are here, yes, to help people to learn about healing, to learn about that physical healing and that emotional healing and that mental, the issues that they have to go through, but also the spiritual healing. Also the, how can you be more in alignment with yourself, even in dire circumstances or situations? And you are here to help heal, not just people in certain situations, but the entire planet in their ability to choose to be in alignment.
Thank you for explaining that.
We thank you. Thank you so much for watching this entire session. Please let me know in the comments if you had any insights, if you had any inspirations while watching it. Please make sure also to like this video so that the algorithm knows to propose it to other people who would benefit from it. And of course, subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you're notified when there are new videos here on this channel with me and Vagrein.